As human beings, or humans being, we sometimes focus a lot on whether we can trust each other. How's your trust of self? I'm Christine Saxon. I am an executive leadership coach. I am the author of Paddle Your Own Boat. And I get to do this. I get to come out in my kayak and paddle and share stuff with you. Share things that might be helpful. Share things that, you know, they don't all come from up here, from me. They come from these amazing people who trust me and trust themselves and reach out for coaching, reach out for reinforcement of habits they want to shift. I'm having a wonderful experience recently. I've taken up a contract coaching female and, female and non-binary entrepreneurs or future entrepreneurs. And when they first join the program, I'm noticing a trend that a lot of them are, they have a concept, they have idea, right? Think of those times when you're just like, there's this thing I want to do. And we start doing it, like some of these entrepreneurs are, and realize we're not really trusting ourselves. You know, there's a lot of talk about imposter syndrome. As I say that, I wonder how many of you are going, yeah, I feel that. Yeah, I experience that. Am I an imposter? Am I going to be found out? Will people realize that the emperor has no clothes? Is no one telling me that I'm actually not qualified? Am I taking on too much? Who am I to think I could launch this business? There's so many of these things that people share openly with me as a trusted coach, and they trust me. And what is underneath it a lot of times is a lowering of their trust of self. Think about this for yourself. What might be going on for you right now? In your work, in your inner thoughts, in your ruminations, in your holding backs, in relationships, in choosing what's best for you, that might reflect lower self-trust than you've had before. Or maybe trust of self is something you're consistently working on improving. Whatever the case, you are so not alone. Trust of self ebbs and flows. The tide is coming in right now. I'm out in a harbor, in the beautiful, beautiful Pender Harbor area where I have a little trailer by the sea and come here to write and reflect and work and play. And as the ebbs and flows were just happening with its high tide and with the tide coming in, I started thinking about these ebbs and flows that we go through as humans. And one of them is in trusting ourselves, trusting our thoughts, our feelings, our gut, our intuition. I'll share with you right now a strategy that I use today with one of my valued, wonderful clients, people who trust me and trust themselves and get coaching. What I said to her is, okay, I hear you, right? It sounds like, you know, you're talking about imposter syndrome. And from over here, I want to share what I'm noticing. Is that okay? And she said, yeah, please do. I said, I'm noticing from knowing you that your trust of self is lower than it's been before. And she paused. And I said, what are you hearing that for yourself? And she just went, it is. I'm not trusting my gut. I'm not listening to that inner voice. In fact, I'm blocking out the inner voice with my doubts and my no, it could never work, or no, that's ridiculous, or no, I'm silly, and even worse, self-talk that happens to us. And so here's a strategy you can try for yourself and for others. It comes from the concept of remind. I read a book years ago about reminding is about reminding. Bringing yourself back to your mind. So I said to her, let's remind a little bit right now. What would you, with high self-trust, recommend to you right now in this moment? And her shoulders went down. And she took a breath. She thought about it. And out came the most supportive, realistic, eloquently worded, clear tips, advice, words of encouragement, words of support from her when I'm feeling self-trust, self, speaking to herself in that moment. And I didn't need to do work, right? I help people do their work. So I listened and I said, I hear you. That sounds like you, doesn't it? I just held space with her and was about to say, you could, I wonder, and what if, and I said, I have some ideas, but first you. What are your ideas right now? And she came up with next steps. She crossed that threshold. She went, oh my gosh, I do trust myself. I'm having a day, Christine. Like we all do. She just oozed self-compassion, realistic expectations of herself, and her energy shifted considerably. So a gift to yourself, a gift to others around you. When you notice, right, the three steps I use with coach in my coaching often and that I encourage people to keep in their pocket is notice it, name it. Oh, you can't see my fingers. Notice it, name it, and navigate it. So I said, what are you noticing now? She said, oh, I'm noticing I have my energy back and I actually want to go. Is it okay if we cut the call short? Because I want to make this list of things that I need to do now. And I said, name a few. And she named some of them. I said, how are you going to do it? And she said, oh, and she told me exactly what her plan was. She shifted with a little bit of help into trust of self. This is not about being perfect, folks. Life is not about being perfect. There is nothing wrong, nothing right in how all of that went. It was simply beautiful paddling. Happy paddling.